Hi friends, today we will discuss the important topic waterlogging. Waterlogging refers to the condition when the air is completely or partially replaced by the water. When it is completely replaced by water, we can call it as saturation, and this saturation condition prolongs for a longer period. The condition we call it as waterlogging. So here important points to be noted are, one is air is replaced by water and it is a prolonged period of waterlogging, that is air being replaced by the water. So there is condition we call it as reduced condition of the soil, which ultimately depletes availability of air, particularly oxygen, and that hampers the respiration of the roots, and definitely that affects the growth of the crop. We many times we see this condition in the fields, reduced growth of the plant and ultimately death of the plant also. So we will see what are the important factors that affect waterlogging and what is the effect of waterlogging. So what are the important factors? Crops means what type of crops. Waterlogging has its impact on depending upon the crops, stage of the crop, duration of the waterlogging, and climatic condition of the period when waterlogging is there. So first one is crops. So in case of crops, there are susceptible crops as well as tolerant crops. As we know, the best resistant crop is the rice. But we should have the focus upon the susceptible crops, because we want to have those crops free from this waterlogging. So tobacco, tomato, chili and pulses, we have to concentrate this factor also. Pulses are very susceptible to the waterlogged conditions. Pulses, as we know, these are the leguminous crops. They have dependability on rhizobium for the nitrogen, and this nitrogen is aerobic because it requires oxygen for its microbial activities, and definitely if oxygen is not there, rhizome activity will not be there, root activity will not be there, and hence in general pulses are quite susceptible to these waterlogged conditions. Whereas, as we know, rice has its capacity, it has erenchymatous tissues, and hence that it is resistant to the waterlogged conditions. Stages also important point to be discussed, because in case of stages there are different stages: germination, then seedling and reproduction. Amongst three, the most susceptible stage is germination, because in germination all the seed is dependent upon oxygen or air around it at the time of germination, because there is no root that will provide some kind of oxygen for the respiration, suppose erenchymatous tissue or that. But in case of germination, seed has to depend upon the soil for the availability of air. So if that, in that condition, if there is no oxygen or water is only present, germination will not be there if our air is not there, and the most susceptible stage is the germination. Whereas in case of pulses, not only germination but up to early period of reproductive stage, pulses are susceptible. Means throughout the period, we can say pulses are susceptible for the waterlogged condition. Whereas in case of cereals, up to panicle initiation, we can see if there is waterlogged condition in case of bajra, jowar, then there is stunted growth or reduced growth of the crop. In case of climate, warm climate is more injurious than the cold climate. It is obviously seen by in tobacco, when flooding is there, when sunshine hours are there, there is flopping and wilting of tobacco. Means that warm climate is more injurious than the cold climate in case of waterlogging. So these are the different factors that affect waterlogging. Now, what is the impact of waterlogging on soil and plant? So in case of soil, it is very clear. It is on the air part only. That is, what kind of changes occurs? As we see, aerobic condition is transferred to anaerobic condition, and this reduced condition is called as redox potential of the soil. means there is less oxygen, it cannot exchange oxygen, and that is lack of oxygen results into the effect on the respiration. Also, simultaneously there is increase of other hazardous gases like hydrocarbon gases, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, and this leads to toxicity to the plants, particularly to the roots. Also, in case of nutrients, more impact is on nitrogen, particularly by two processes. One is denitrification and leaching of nitrates. As nitrates are mobile, so they leach out with the water by moving water, and also there is denitrification. So there is loss of nitrogen, and this increase of certain toxic gases, and this reduction in oxygen. In case of plants, shoot elongation, senescence of leaves, oxygen layer, also production of adventitious roots in the tissues of the plants is commonly seen when there is a waterlogged condition. Also, anaerobic respiration is observed instead of aerobic respiration, and this leads to the improper growth of the crop, stunted growth of the crop. If waterlogged condition is prolonged, then there is ethanol, particularly the activity of alcohol dehydrogenase increases, and it is responsible for reduced permeability of the plant tissues. Reduced permeability reduces the uptake of the nutrients, and ultimately plant shows wilting symptoms. Means, although there is a water, plant shows the wilting symptoms because of reduced permeability of the plant tissues. And this is observed under waterlogged condition. This is very important. Means wilting occurs although there is a water, excess water under waterlogged condition. And this leads to the death of the crop also sometimes. So this is all about waterlogged condition. We need to tackle this issue because we know we are not only having the problem of dryland agriculture, but in dryland agriculture, if such condition is for 8 or 9 days also, we get maximum losses. So we need to concentrate on this issue and solve this waterlogged condition. So drainage is one of the way to escape from the situation. So we'll see in next chapter. Thank you.